And so we've gone through transitions and times in our life where we're constantly struggling to balance justice and grace. But now we live in an era and in a culture that has gone even one step further. And again, I'm not getting into the politics of this, and I'm not just pointing at things that have happened, but let me just point out some instances that I think might resonate in a whole different way. What we used to call pornography. Pornography. You know, Playboy magazine when I was growing up, now the internet. Whether you subscribe to it, you're going to get blasted with it. You have to be careful. Pornography. That's what we used to call it, pornography. But today we call it adult entertainment. Not pornography, adult entertainment, all right? Or what about adultery? Do you hear people talking about adultery anymore? That you committed sin outside of the marriage, either with the person that's married or not married, and you've committed that sin. We don't call it an adultery anymore. We call it, oh, they're having an affair. You know, that sounds so much less threatening than adultery. Adultery sounds like sin, doesn't it? But if they're having an affair, well, it could be a social affair or a gathering affair or a food affair, but we really know what it means. Or what about premarital sex? We don't talk about it as premarital sex anymore. We talk about it as, oh, fooling around. Fooling around. See how things have changed from adultery, pornography, premarital sex to adult entertainment, having an affair, or fooling around. It seems that we're accelerating in our culture and the degradation of our culture to the extent that 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 3 says, "For a time is coming when people will no longer listen to sound and wholesome teaching. They will follow their own desires." Say desires.
Desires.
You know, we talk about being led astray, but the thing that leads us astray the most is not the enemy, although he works in this way, but it's our own desires, which will look for teachers who will tell them whatever their itching ears want to hear. That's the truth of 2 Timothy. And it emphasizes the fact that sin is real, and it has serious earthly consequences, and it has possibly damning eternal consequences. Sin is pleasurable for the season. As many of you know, you've heard me quote him many, many times. Ike Newingham was my campus life director growing up, and he was famous for saying, if anyone says sin isn't fun, they just haven't sinned enough, or the right ones. Sin is pleasant. It's fun. It's fun for a season. But it has consequences afterwards.